Hello, Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 100 Mobile Sumo from Turning Gundam. This kit came out in 1999, and look at the bling on this thing. It is pretty amazing. I love the chrome. I love everything about it. It's really good, considering the time. It is a fingerprint magnet. And you might be able to see me. Hello. Now, I have to say, after building this, they had some work to do on the joints. It's not very tight anywhere. It has a lot of joints, but it doesn't really, it'll stand. But it doesn't take much to flop it over. Everything seems a little too loose. It's weird, because it's basically constructed like the wing kits, the X kits, the G Gundam kits, and yet none of them are this bad. I've never had anyone so floppy before. Don't really get it. But let's look at the one sticker I have on the kit, which is the head. Just the one. It actually is a full sticker. You have like both halves of the face, it's covered on one side. Or you could replace it with this. But that means taking the entire head apart. And these orange parts are stickers. The only stickers on the kit. Or on the body. And I do like the segmented parts of like the gray and the dark brown. This part, I don't think these were on the 1/144 scale. But you could easily get rid of them. Just do that, and then it looks a little more like the high grade. But no, they weren't high grades, were they? I think they were. Anyways. But yeah, it does look good, and it looks like the clear cockpit. It is a cockpit. Well, it's almost. Well, looks more like a tablet, a pill. It's a Tylenol. But it does have a seat in there. There is no pilot, but it is there. So, yeah, I love the way it looks. It's a cool design, but man, maybe it was just mine, but every single joint is loose. I can't believe it's just mine. So, yeah, it looks great, but it holds together. It doesn't fall apart. It's too loose to support its own weight in a lot of poses. Now, speaking of poses, the head is ball jointed. It mostly rotates, you can get a little up and down. The arms will rotate. If you take these parts off, it'll go all the way around and go out. And this part is actually two separate pieces, but I find they usually fall down once again. It's loose. And go out, rotate at the elbow, bend that one joint at the elbow. You got the ball jointed wrist. You have the old Master Grade style fingers with the three together, the one trigger finger separate. Although the thumb doesn't move. The waist is interesting. It goes forward and backwards at the top of the stomach, and then it'll go side to side at the bottom, but also rotate. And that goes out of the way, so you can have it go forward. The legs will go... Okay, they're really weird. Because they're very tight. The only part that's tight is here at the hip. It'll go forward, it'll go back, and it can go out some. But then there's also a joint in here which also goes out. So you have this joint that goes out, but then this joint that goes out, which also rotates. And then you have a hinge up here, but then a hinge down here, which goes more forward than back. Actually, it goes about the same. It goes really far forward. It's very strange. And there's also a panel here which shows off some thrusters. I guess they're thrusters. Cool detail. And then the ankle armor is hinged. I'm sorry, I'm probably blinding you multiple times. And then you get a ball jointed foot, which can rotate side to side, forward and back, and the toes can move up and down too, but once again, they're also very loose. So while it does have a surprising amount of articulation for the time, almost 20 years ago, you can get into poses, you just gotta be really careful, because it's not too hard to get him to start to collapse and sag. But it does work. You can do it. So yeah, it has really good articulation for the time. So you've got this thing, which is like a shield, I guess. It has two stickers on it. And... really? Alright. I did say it wouldn't fall apart. Oh. But I'll just plug in like that. And I should mention, before I forget, nothing is under gears. I thought it might be. It's all nubs. You can see a lot of numbers on here. On here. They're not super noticeable, I don't think, anyways. But they're definitely there. But they're not as noticeable as I thought they might be. Now this thing also has like a beam effect. You got this little one here, which will just plug in like that. And then you have another one, which I guess is a beam, kind of beam saber. Which will do that. And that's cool. It's different. And then you have the physical weapon that it has, which can rotate here. It's actually on like a ball joint. It's kind of weird. And it can be held in the hand. I just gotta kind of... Whoa, hand, where are you going? Let's try that again. Just gotta wrap the hand around it. It is weird looking, but then again, this whole thing is weird looking. And then you also have a stored version of it, which does flip out on a hinge. It's just a hinge. You could technically hold it too, I suppose, but mine broke. It broke. I was just holding it to peg it together, and it broke in half. Kind of weird. Doesn't hold together that well, but it's mostly made. It's really just used to store. Like, so you can have it as a stored weapon instead of in the hand. It's got these two pegs, which kind of fit into these rectangular holes. I don't know why they're rectangles. But it will hold. I've had it in there. It's just really a strange connection having rectangular holes and little round pegs. But then again, that Master Grade Goof had them too, and it came out a year later. So, okay. And then you have what I assume is a beam rifle. I assume that's what it's called. With some more gold. That is on a hinge. It has a similar kind of handle. And if I can get this out of the hand. Yeah, the fingers are tight. And you can kind of get this wrapped around. And there that is. Yeah, these weapons are friggin' weird. I do like the beam saber thing. But yeah, they're all really weird looking. So yeah, it just got weird accessories. That's the only thing I can say. So, despite being an older mobile suit, they did, I think, get it into the right scale. Here is the Hazel, which is a bigger mobile suit in terms of, like, a Gundam. And then the Master Grade Turne. So it's about the right height. It's bigger than a normal Gundam. And it's a lot bulkier. I think it works well. In terms, I might like it better if it was the same gold color as the Master Grade 2.0 Hayakushiki, because I like the chrome, but I think it's a little too much, because it's all pretty much chrome. There's only like, there's very little non-chrome compared to chrome. So that is the 1100 Sumo. It's weird. It is a weird mobile suit. I'm glad I have it. I always wanted it. And it's strange. It's, my biggest complaint is just everything is so friggin' loose on this thing. Nothing is solid. Except for the fingers. Strangely enough. Usually that's the weaker part. But yeah, it's just, it looks weird. Holds together weird. Has weird accessories. I think that's the word of the day. It's weird. Now fall over. There we go. So that's about it. And I'll see you in the next review.